In this video, a company wants to build a lead management system to handle leads coming in from various channels and with varied levels of interest in the products. The leads need to be processed and classified into different buckets based on the marketing criteria and need to be stored in the company's leads database. We'll demonstrate how the enterprise architect can design an application to seamlessly integrate Salesforce with DB2 via Kafka using data schemas. First, we'll create an event-driven flow in IBM App Connect using Salesforce and Kafka nodes. Here, we'll add the Salesforce New Lead node and Kafka Send Message node that will sync leads to Kafka based on different schemas, based on the source of the leads generated, the details captured, etc. In the Kafka Send Message node, we'll choose a topic where we want to put the message containing lead details. And then we'll choose the Avro or JSON format for schema that will be used to encode the message consisting of lead details. Once the pop-up appears, we will select subject name and then schema version, and then we'll click on apply, which will then render the schema of our choice. Now we'll map all the fields of the generated schema accordingly. In this flow, every time a new lead is found for this particular schema, a Kafka send message will be triggered. Next, we'll create another event-driven flow using the Kafka and JDBC node. This flow will get triggered every time a new lead event is found. In this flow, we'll add a Kafka new message node and a JDBC custom query node. In the Kafka New Message node, we will again choose the same topic that we chose for the action flow, and the same schema will be used to decode the message sent by the action flow. For that, we'll click on Select Output Schema. Once the pop-up appears, we will select schema type similar to what we chose on the action side, and then the same subject name, and then schema version, and then we'll click on Apply, which will then render the same schema that we had for the action flow. We can change the output schema by clicking on Change Output Schema, and again, the same schema settings pop-up will appear where we can choose a different schema. After that, we'll perform a custom query action with the insert query on the SF Leads table to insert the lead details in the corresponding table by mapping values from the selected output schema. Now we'll start both the flows. After that, we'll go to the Salesforce page and we'll add a new lead to it. This lead creation will trigger our first flow, and then we'll insert the lead details in the SF Leads table by triggering the second flow. After that, we'll perform select query on the SF Leads table to check whether the new lead details were added into the table. As we can see, whatever lead we created in the Salesforce page has been added to the Salesforce Leads table in IBM DB2. We have shown by using the flows created in IBM App Connect, we designed an application to integrate Salesforce with DB2 via Kafka, using a specific schema.